Well, welcome. My name is Ron Donato. I'm the Program Director for the Program International Business, Finance and Trade, the single degree and the double degree. So what I want to do is, one, is not keep you here for the full 45 minutes, so just to keep your interest level going. But what I want to do is just briefly give an overview of the program, a brief overview, and then spend time just going through question and answer, because really it's the interactive effect that where most of you guys are able to develop an interest. So so the structure is that I'll go through the structure of the program itself. We'll look at the career options, the skills that students get, etc. We've also got a student ambassador, one of our students, current second year students, and she'll be able to give you a 5 minute spiel about why she chose the program. So what I want to do first is, I've only shown this video once before, and it's an older version of me, because I'm a lot younger now, of just a 3 minute overview of a broad brush stroke of our program. And so you better see me with the wind blowing in my hair, and then we can get started.
Hi, I'm Dr. Ron Donato. I'm one of the lecturers involved in the International Business degree. We're here to tell you about the features of the program. In particular, the importance of the business skills students acquire and the great career opportunities that open up for our graduates.
My name is Ashley. I recently completed an International Business degree at UniSA. I currently work at the South Australian Government Department of Trade and Economic Development.
My name is Lloyd Sexton, final year International Business student, currently working at ASC in their graduate program.
I'm Julia Hanksari. I studied International Business at UniSA and I now work for BAE Systems Australia.
I'm Donna McGee and I'm currently studying Honours, having recently completed International Business.
I'm Trent Moore and I'm studying International Business.
I'm Hannah Wheaton. I'm studying International Business and International Studies.
International Business is about real people in the real world, real firms, real institutions, and the courses that we teach allow students to engage with those real behaviours.
We want students to know how to structure a firm. Where would you sell your products? Who would you sell your products to? Where would you buy your products from if you're importing products? And how would you acquire funds? How would you borrow money in the global financial markets?
There are two important features of the International Business Program. First, flexibility. The core subjects in the program will provide you with strong conceptual, analytical and problem-solving skills that can be applied in a variety of business settings. This means you don't have to choose your career path in advance. Second, these skills are taught in the international context, which is so essential in our globalised marketplace. Students also have the opportunity to study overseas on one of the most generous scholarship arrangements offered in South Australia.
I did an exchange in Vienna, in Austria, overseas for 6 months. It was a fantastic experience and I'd recommend it to anyone who is interested.
Students have options to do a single international business degree or a double degree with international studies involving languages. Importantly also, the program directly leads into the honours program. Underpinning the International Business degree are the quality of the academic staff, who are eminent scholars in their research fields, have authored national prize-winning textbooks, and have received numerous teaching excellence awards.
So the academic staff are all really passionate about what they do, and definitely very knowledgeable in their fields, and always more than happy to help.
First year microeconomics with Ken Adams really inspired us.
From the first year level, they really engaged me, and I really felt there was a high level of program support throughout my degree.
Employers these days are looking for employees who can think critically about the real world and understand why things happen, and so it's great to be associated with program that teaches students to do that.
International Business offers a number of highly regarded advanced courses such as econometrics and competitive strategy, and they were pivotal in me gaining my position as a graduate with ASE.
We take an analytically rich approach to student learning, so what rewards me is when students actually get the rigour and the analytical process involved in the course. That's enriching.
I'm well on my way in establishing my career in international business, and I would definitely recommend this program to students wanting a career in business.
It's opened up some new opportunities and it enabled me to be promoted to my current position.
The degree gave me analytical and conceptual thinking skills, which are highly valued by my employer.
I highly recommend international business for its flexibility and international focus.
I definitely recommend the course. The subjects are interesting, the teachers are passionate, and the opportunities are endless.
If you're serious about succeeding in the business world, this degree gives you the ability to realise your career ambitions. Check out the program structures on the UniSA website now.
Well, you can obviously see how underpaid academics are, because I've just realised it's the same shirt and the same jacket. Obviously not to do with an expanded wardrobe, I think. Okay, so that is just as I said, a broad brush spiel in relation to our program. What I want to do now is, if I can just find the right button to press, is just look at some of the details. Well, we read about it in the paper. Everything that we do now is internationally linked. The world is global. Australia is part of that global network. And so this program deliberately focuses on that international dimension of business studies. Okay? In terms of a definition, it's the study of how economic activity and business decisions are conducted in the global business environment. What we like about our program is the fact that you develop a set of skills. A set of skills that you can only learn in a university or in a scholastic environment that you then take out. There's a range of vocational skills that you pick up when you're in the job, but there's a range of core skills that we think that we impart to our students that will take them across the spectrum. So the type of skills, and I'll discuss this in general later, is that there's analytical skills, decision-making skills, there's conceptual skills that students will pick from this program, will get from this program, and they'll also develop skills in particular vocational areas as well. But specifically, in relation to the sort of courses, now you guys, I assume you've been here for a few hours, and so you'd be familiar with the rough structure of courses in this division. So no matter what you do in this division, you all do the same first year courses, right? Whether you do HR or tourism or management, accounting, whatever it is, you'll end up doing the same first year courses. And then there are courses that are specific to the program. Okay, so you'll do first year management, first year accounting, first year economics, etc. So in addition to those first year courses, then we lead to our specific core courses. All right, and that's what this shows. So the core courses above first year that's specific to us are macroeconomics, on top of principles economics, international economics, finance and investment, forecasting and business analysis, international business law, commercial law, and strategy, a competitive strategy. So these are specific to our program. And on top of that, students, because there are a range of electives that students do in their program, right, that they also do. And so within that, you'll be choosing a set of electives within these sequences on top. So in addition to the core courses that you'll do in our program, you'll also do a set of courses within economics and public policy, or international marketing and management, or applied finance. So in addition to, our core courses, there are some specific courses that you will choose within that. And also you get to study overseas, which I'll briefly talk about that anyway. So if you were to, and I know, you know, it's universal now, look at the web. Look at the web is what you see with everything. But if you do look at the web, you'll navigate your way through this. I'm just taking a shortcut. But we just look at our 2011 degree. If you do look at the web, then you'll be able to see the structure of our program. First year, second year, third year. Right? And so here are all our first year courses. And then when we get to second year, we start coming into these core courses specific to our program. International business law, forecasting, international economics, finance, investment. They start to kick in second year. You see that. But you can see that there are a range of electives. Electives, elective, 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 elective. Doo-doo-doo. So in here you've got competitive strategy, which is our other core course. So you've got our core courses plus all your electives, which are around what we call professional business sequence that I just highlighted, that you must choose two business sequences within your program. So here, again, as I stated, here are your core courses, and then you must choose two professional business sequences, either applied economics policy and international marketing, or that and that, or etc. And so in here, you can actually see the individual courses that you do as part of the sequence. All right, so you know, if you were doing international marketing and management, you would do Buyer and Consumer Behavior, international marketing, foundations in HR, comparative human resource management. So I guess what I would say to you is, you know, do have a look at the website so you've got a more detailed structure. And that'll be with all your programs. So here within the division, all the programs have got a similar format. So once you get used to knowing how to navigate your way through one, you can have a look at the other programs as well. So that's the setup. So here are the individual courses, as I said, within the professional sequence. So just hopping back. So as I said, what we do want to do is that we want to develop a range. Let me have a quick look at. So what we do want to do is have students develop a range of skills that you pick up here. So for instance, developing conceptual skills, right? So with this program, for instance, you'll be doing courses like macroeconomics, international economics, right? And you don't have to have done economics before because you start from first year. But economics is a conceptual discipline. The world out there is incredibly complex. Millions and millions of decisions are done every day. Okay, there's no single big brother coordinating all those decisions, but they are made, right? And we have to bring order to that. How do we understand that complex world where billions of decisions are made every second? How do we do that? Well, we conceptualize. We bring order and we simplify that world in the form of model building. So what we'll do in the program is to find ways to use your mind to think of complexity and to simplify that, and then to use that as a model. And then what happens when you start changing parameters? So what happens, for instance, if the exchange rate goes through the roof? What does that mean? What's this thing about a two-speed economy? What's this thing called Dutch disease, and does it affect Australia? Well, what does the euro debt mean in the context of China, and what does China mean in the context of Australia? It's a complex world, and to be able to think conceptually that complex world becomes a feature of the sort of skills that you actually pick up. All right? So you'll have so there's a series of courses that will cover that. And of course you can go deeper if you go into, say, economics and public policy, where there are more advanced courses in relation to that. Okay. So you've also got technical skills. Right? So you can't expect to be able to embrace the business world, the economic world, and not have any idea about numbers. Right? You must know and be able to use numbers, okay, not in a straight technical sense, but in a way that provides information. Right? Numbers provides information, or data provides information upon which decisions are made. Decision making is based on information, and data is that source. So in addition to, you know, your first year courses, which is, you know, your first year quantitative methods, so you all students who come here will do a first year simple maths, quant methods type course. In second year, we'll take you further and we'll look at being able to use data in a way that provides information for forecasting, etc. Being able to look at relationships. Look at the relationship between exchange rates and Australian economic activity. Looking at the issue between GDP growth and retail sales for an individual organisation. So students will develop a set of technical skills that will enable them to become decision makers down the track. All right? And so you can't say, well, look, I'm really good at business, but I don't like numbers. It's a bit like saying in accounting, I'm really good at debits, but I'm hopeless at credits. Or I'm good with my left hand, but not with my right hand or something. So then the nature of the program is designed to enable students to develop a well-rounded set of skills that they take with them. I mean, when you go to an employer, they're not going to bother sitting down with you and how to do long division and how to use an Excel spreadsheet and how to use forecasting techniques. You went to uni for that. They're not going to say, okay. So, and that's what this is meant to do. This is meant to give you the skills that employers expect you to already have. And the same thing will come with the issue in relation to decision making. Right? Issues of strategy. How to problem solve. And so we've got a couple of courses around that. Finance and investment strategy provides an approach to how you go about looking at complex problems and how to solve them in a strategic manner. So, you know, it's more than just optimizing. It's more than just about organizations making decisions, given their circumstances, how to optimize profits, maximize their objectives within constraints. I mean, we do that. But the next step is, what happens if the entire world's moving? So you've got this world that is dynamic and is moving, and you've got to make decisions under uncertainty. Okay? So which protocol is going to bubble to the top? Is it high-definition DVDs or Blu-ray? So how does Sony, which wanted to push Blu-ray, how does it confront its strategy when knowing that one of two protocols is going to eventually bubble up? Okay? And of course, you know, what they did is that they bundled it with their PlayStation 3. They got huge numbers, they got a critical mass, and then they were able to, that became the major protocol. Now we're looking at the same thing with the next generation technologies in relation to your iPads and your tablets and what's going to be the operating system that's going to dominate, whether it's going to be Android or whatever. And so, so decision making, strategic decision making, when the world's a dynamic place, okay, again requires sort of high level thinking skills. And so the aim here is to be able to do that, that we incorporate courses that will do that. And then, as I said, within that, you then choose particular sequences to augment your program. And so it's not for me to say, well, look, you know, son, marketing is for you, right? You've got all these other skills, okay? Or son, HR is for you. So what you've got is that you've got a choice to be able to tailor your electives around a couple of vocational areas. And so you've got international marketing and management, you've got economics and public policy, you've got finance. Okay, and of course, if you can convince me that there are sequences of courses that you think are better than the ones that we have got, then you can make an appointment to see me, and we can work out a way to add value to the program and modify the program that specifically suits you. All right. So nothing is set in concrete, but what we don't want is students to come up and say, "Look, you know, I want to get out of here in the easiest way possible." And what are the easiest first-year courses that have no exams so I can just do my electives that way? Well, you ain't going to get a yes from me on that basis. Right? But you have students who are saying, look, I'm starting off with Japanese 3 and I want to go all the way to honours Japanese and I want to get to interpreter level, and there's not many people in the world who is fluent in both languages, da-da-da. Well, then I'm happy to allow students to do ultra-advanced Japanese courses in lieu of something else. So there's a range of alternatives in a way that adds value to your program. You get one crack at this, really. And so this is a chance to enable students to really add value and come out with a really powerful degree. All right. So what we do is that we tailor it, but at the same time, it broadens your career options. So you don't actually have to start off, I'm going to be the world's best HR and that's the job I'm going to do. I'm going to be the world's best marketing person, that's what I'm going to do. Okay, you can go across a range of business positions with the exception of those that have professional requirements, you know, whether it's property or law. Okay, but other than that, you have that full range. I won't bore you with that. I'm sure that's written somewhere about you need... It's been rising over the last few years. I don't know what it'll be. It might be 72, 73. I mean, it has been rising over the last couple of years, but that shouldn't be a constraint. All right. Just to highlight also that we've got a double degree, a dedicated double degree with international relations. So we've got so you do international business with international relations, which is taught out at McGill, and in there students do international relations courses. Okay, so it's one extra year, and they do languages, okay, and also they choose. There's an overseas exchange, and they get to choose a sequence within their international studies. So what happens with this double degree is that you do 2 years of international business, and 2 years of international relations. And so in the past, what we've had is some pretty bright students who have done double degrees, although I can't speak for Heidi's background. But what we have had in the past are a lot of really bright art students who know that, well, what I'm going to do with a straight arts degree, why don't I augment that with business? And so we've had some really bright art students who wouldn't have contemplated normally doing business, but doing it and realise that they can handle it because they're bright students. And it's a way then to be able to capture a cohort of bright students, and they enjoy the program. So that's our double degree specifically with international relations, okay? But you can also do a double degree within business. So you can do a double degree with this and any other business program within the division. But that is done internally. So after first year, you want to do a double degree with international business, a single degree, plus with marketing, then you can do that. So after first year, providing you pass your courses, then you can switch across to an internal business double degree. So for one extra year, you get to then get a second degree. You just have to reschedule your program because you can't do marketing 1, 2, 3, and 4 in one semester. You've got to space that out because of the prerequisites. So you can do that. And that's with any business program within the division. And that's just a simple administrative thing. Okay. The other thing, and I'm not too sure if that's on there, is is there an overseas thing? Okay. The other thing, of course, is that what I haven't shown there is there's an overseas studies component to both. So you can choose to go overseas. And where are you going, Heidi?
Vienna.
Vienna. So that sounds pretty tough. So you can get to go overseas and spend a semester over there as part of your program. In the case of the double degree, it's already built in. In the single degree, there's a semester available, but you can swap that semester depending on when you want to go, and that becomes one of your professional sequences. Okay? So if you want to, and that's a great way of being able to, expose yourself to the international problem. There's the scholarship arrangements. Usually, virtually every one of our business students will get a division of business scholarship of about $2,000 to $3,000. And there are other scholarships that are available as well. And the sort of fees that you would pay here, the HECS is, you still just pay the Australian HECS fees rather than the overseas fees. Now, this is, this is quite standard for UniSA that we do have quite extensive external online. So virtually all our courses you can do online. But that's really, either because of work commitments, you're a part-time student, or you live in Broken Hill or something, right? Ideally, if you live in Adelaide, and if it's not because of work or whatever, then you should really do it internally. But nevertheless, everything is offered in an external type mode through online. We do have summer schools, mainly for the big courses, so there's ways of being able to accelerate your program, all right? And we can talk about that. The double degree I've already highlighted. Skills, decision-making skills within an international context. And so there's a broad range of skills that students acquire, which then means that they have the opportunity to choose from a range of business graduate positions. So as I said, unless they want accounting students with accounting quals or property students with property quals, you can virtually apply for any business graduate position. All our graduates, and certainly all our good graduates, all get jobs with top employers, whether it's, as you said, BAE Systems or SA Development, Trade and Development. We've even had spies for in Canberra, okay, the Treasury and Finance and Health, and whether it's with the ANZ Bank or whether it's with Qantas, whether it's the Adelaide Submarine Corps, you name it, any organisation that wants business graduates that have a set of skills, the skills being, a high level of written communication skills, good technical skills, good thinking skills, problem solving skills, etc. And so the jobs are numerous in terms of the opportunities. Okay. Now, what we'll do is that we'll have Heidi, who's been waiting patiently up there. She's our second year double degree student, who will give us give you guys a 5-minute spiel about the program, and then we'll wind up with you want this, or you gonna stick to one spot? And then we'll have question and answer. Okay?
Thank you.
Well, no one's allowed to leave unless there's at least two questions, either to myself or to Heidi. So no matter how trivial you may think it is, it's probably quite relevant to others. So someone would like to ask particular questions about the program or what one can do outside of the program or what the first year or second year is like? Come on, guys, we need one. So it's all worked out, is it? Got it. So you've understood everything. All right. Okay, well, I'll reduce it to one question. Ah, great. We can all leave. Yeah. And there are discussion forums and all that sort of thing as well. So it's almost like having a virtual tutorial session. So any queries about overseas exchange or mixing and matching courses, etc.? All right, well, we did get that one question, so he's taken it for the team. So, guys, we're on email. If you've got any specific queries, I think there might be another slide, actually. So you can either email me. I'm on the web, of course, and Lynn Nipperis, she's the student administrator. So, and look at the website as well, because that will really give you an understanding of how it's structured. Okay. So we wish you well for next year. I think the fact that you guys are here in the first place means that you're well on your way. So all the best, and we'll catch you next year.